Now, in view is the Cygnus cargo craft. You can start seeing the solar arrays at the side. You see the back left there? Those are those ultraflex solar arrays on Cygnus, again, about 800 meters away from station. Less than 5 meters away from the holding point, actually closer to about 34 meters away from the International Space Station. Rate is slowing down just a bit now, about 0.04 meters per second, closing in on that 30-meter holding point. From then, again, ground teams will assess whether or not to move towards that capture position. So Paolo Nespoli aboard the International Space Station, now working with Randy Bresnik, can use the station's robotic arm to capture the Cygnus cargo vehicle. Flight controllers just flip the camera to its to get a better view of the station's robotic arm and Cygnus. Again, Cygnus holding it about 30 meters away from the station. You can see the tip of the station's robotic arm there, sort of toward the center of your screen. That's where Cygnus is heading next after the go for departing the 30-meter holding point. It'll go just about around the range of 10 meters away from the International Space Station, about 10 or 12. That'll get it into its position almost perfectly, so Paolo Nespoli just has to push the controls forward, and right there you can see the latching end effector will grab the Cygnus vehicle, and right now we're looking at a capture time just around the vicinity of 4 a.m. Central Time. Still, we'll keep you updated if anything changes, but again, 4 a.m. Central Time for that capture time. In the meantime, we'll wait for the call to depart the 30-meter holding point. Now passing 13 meters away from the station, about 12.5 now. You can see the west coast of South Africa, International Space Station, 257 statute miles above the Earth. Cygnus cargo vehicle just over 12 meters away from that. Station just about to pass over Cape Town, South Africa. Now 2 meters away, everything looking good so far. Now over the pin, in the capture envelope, with that the carriage is driving, and driving the final commands to capture the Cygnus vehicle, 4:04 a.m. Central Time today. Over the southeastern Indian Ocean, just southwest of Australia. robotics officers working through the installation process now. Right now, at the end of the station's robotic arm, is the Cygnus vehicle moving towards the nadir port, the Earth-facing port of the Unity module, where it will stay for the next few weeks up until early December. The installation process will include the station's robotic arm driving it into that port. There are four gangs of four bolts, 16 bolts total, that need to be driven to complete the installation process. There's the first and second stage capture. On the second stage will be the official berthing time for today. If you look closely, you can see the Cygnus cargo vehicle slowly moving right in front of the common berthing mechanism that you can see right there in the middle of your screen. Cygnus cargo vehicle on board is about 7,400 pounds of supplies and equipment. Slower the better for maneuvering such large volumes in space.
Space to ground two, the PCS relocate from the airlock, correction, from the cupola, so the airlock is complete.
We copy, thank you.
So it may look like the Cygnus cargo vehicle is just sort of hanging out there, but there's a lot of going on the back end. Right now, the robotics officers are moving on forward to the ready-to-latch indicators. Once all of them are green-lit, they'll drive the bolts and officially install Cygnus to the International Space Station. So with the flight director confirmation, all 16 bolts have been successfully driven, and second stage capture of an installation of the Cygnus cargo vehicle to the International Space Station has been complete. All 16 bolts were driven and completed at 6:15 a.m. Central Time today, while the International Space Station was 252 statute miles over the North Pacific Ocean during the orbital nighttime.